So we have one more we're going to talk about today, and it's that of the leader class that's new to the Transformers War for Cybertron Kingdom line. We knew about Beast Wars Megatron. We know about the Earthrise leader class Optimus Prime repack. But here's our third one. War for Cybertron Kingdom leader class Ultra Magnus Earth Mode. And from what it looks like, from the package art, from what we could see from that small little window, it looks like they took the Earthrise Siege Ultra Magnus and retooled the hell out of him to make him look like his traditional Generation 1 1986 Earth Mode cab. When you look at the package art, you could see the peg holes that were present on the original. What I'm going to do is I'm going to present the actual packaging of this War for Cybertron Kingdom version, and all the images afterwards that'll be on the bottom will be images of the traditional Siege version to compare. And you will see that there's a lot of comparisons to be drawn here. What I'm even more curious about is I want to see how nice and how different, ultimately in the end, that inner robot mode will look like, the white Magnus, if you will. But looks really good. It looks like everything else is more or less maintained. Maybe they retooled the gun. It's kind of hard to tell from the shot. We're really basing everything off of the art here more than anything else. But it's really good. And I mean, Siege Ultra Magnus was probably one of my favorite non-Micromaster Siege toys from the Siege line. Just because of, you know, how long it took to finally get to this point after so much third-party stuff and even like, you know, stuff like Titaniums and the official masterpiece just not giving us that armored Ultra Magnus with the white Optimus, you know, mold under it. So really cool to finally get that toy. And now, after being so happy with the Siege one, to get the Earthrise, well, I guess the Earth Mode equivalency within Kingdom is even more of a celebration, because now we've finally gone full circle to what we intended from all the way back with, let's say, City Commander and the third party world, and what we were doing with all those white Magnus repaints all those years and upgrade kits from different third party companies, and then ultimately in the end what we have here today. So really awesome stuff. Very happy with how everything turned out. And I mean, some people are kind of unhappy with it because they feel it's kind of a lazy filler. Some people are happy with it because it gives us the true Ultra Magnus. This will be our Cybertronian Ultra Magnus with the Siege one, and this one will be our true Earth one. At the end of the day, I dig it. I like it a lot. I want to see more of that alt mode, so see if it's even more true to that of the original one, because that Siege one, you know, like the sides of the Magnus trailer, it had like those grill patterns and stuff that are seen more with, I guess, like, what's the word I'm looking for? Kind of like livestock travel and stuff like that. So I'm very curious how much they make it look way more like the original design from 1986. That old, you know, powered convoy kind of diaclone design. So I'm really curious. Really, really curious. Needless to say, later today, Saturday night, it is going to be a very interesting stream for the Transformers Slag podcast and all the listeners. It's going to be a very interesting stream of all of us hanging out and talking about this, because we have so much to talk about. This is bananas. But what I like most about this is, now looking at this Magnus, maybe we'll finally also get that powered convoy repaint, the Delta Magnus. Maybe through this we'll get a Shining Magnus, because this is the true mold now of how this character is supposed to be depicted. And I'm very curious where it's going to go with this. Let me know what you think. I like it. I dig it. Rodimus will finally have his second in command proper, and I dig it a lot.